Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and I'm a robotics software engineer who loves to code. The best way I know of learning coding is creating small projects or building simple games. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing 5 projects that you can work on with just level 1 basic coding skills. Today's video is divided in 4 parts: how to learn the fundamentals, how to practice the fundamentals, and 5 simple projects that you can do with just level 1 coding, and last but not the least, how to troubleshoot. This is also your gentle reminder to hit the bell notification when you hit subscribe, so you're notified every time I come up with a new video. So without further ado, let's get into it. This brings us to an important question: which programming language should you get started with? Honestly, it doesn't matter because most of these programming languages have the same core concepts. So if you learn one language, you can very easily pick up the next one. If you do know which field you want to go into, you can use that to narrow down the programming languages that you should get started with. For example, in the field of robotics, both C++ and Python are pretty popular and you can choose either of them. Learning to code is like learning a new language. You have to start with the vocabulary. In other words, you must know the fundamentals before you can get started. This includes handling input-output, creating variables, if-else, and loops. Loops include both while and for loops. A good free resource to get started with learning the fundamental is the new post in YouTube channel by Bucky Roberts. I personally used it to get started with Python. He also has videos on other programming languages such as C++ and Java. The reason I enjoy his videos are they are bite-sized and easy to follow along. I'll include the link in the description below. As I mentioned before, YouTube videos are a great way to get started with learning the fundamentals. They do have one downfall. They very quickly go over the fundamentals. Now, if you want to get good at coding, you need to understand how things work. So make sure to do a few exercises so you can really understand how if-else works, for and while loop work. This is similar to how you would learn to say basic sentences in English before you move on. I know, it's a bit boring. That is why part 3 is about doing small projects or building games that makes it a little bit more fun to learn to code. So here are 5 projects you can use to get started with learning to code. Number 1, guess the number. It's a fun, easy, interactive game between a user and the code. The code starts with a number which can be pre-programmed or you can use a random generator. The user has to guess what that number is. If they get it correct, the computer says it's correct. If they don't get it, then the computer gives some hints as to is the number higher or lower than the actual number. Project 2. Cipher and decipher a message. The user can enter a message and the code will simply change the letters around and give a coded message. When the user enters that coded message along with a password maybe, they can get the deciphered message. You can do this by simply shifting letters by a certain number or creating some formula to change one letter to another letter. Project 3 is about creating beautiful designs on your output terminal. This can be something as simple as creating a pyramid or a circle. If you want to make it fun, you can even create a pyramid of palindrome numbers. This project involves the use of for loop and figuring out how to print statements so you can get a beautiful design. Project number 4, building a calculator. What's great about this project is you start simple and then as you learn more concepts, you can make it into a more advanced calculator. To give you an example, you can start by printing addition and subtraction. You ask user for numbers and then you ask user if they want to add or subtract. And then as you learn more advanced topics such as operation overload, a user can simply type 5 plus 4 and you will print 9 because you know the plus sign means addition. Project number 5, print the sum of the first 1000 prime numbers. This might seem like a simple and probably a boring topic, but once you dig in, you will be blown away. Here's why. Printing the first 10 prime numbers, super easy. Printing the first 1000 prime numbers, not so easy. Coding wise, yes, you can do it, but you'll realize that it is taking forever to even print the first 1000 prime numbers, forget adding it up and printing the sum. Doing this project will help you learn one of the core concepts of coding, logical thinking. Coding isn't just about writing a code. Coding is also about writing a code that works fast. If you write a code that takes forever to run, no one will use it. You need to write a code that can actually produce results super fast. And this is where logical thinking comes in. And this is a perfect project to kind of dive into how you can do things a little faster. This project actually comes from Project Euler. Project Euler is a website where every summer they post mathematical problems that can be solved with a computer code. But the twist is that it actually requires a little bit of smart thinking to get it done really quickly. I'll include the link in the description below. Do check it out. This brings us to part 4, troubleshooting. As you do your exercises and projects, you're going to get into errors and get stuck not knowing what to do next. Now, there are two kinds of errors. Syntax error and logical error. Syntax error are similar to grammatical errors when you're trying to learn a new language. Whereas logical errors is where your code will run, but it will give you an incorrect answer. Just Google it. Trust me, even professionals do it. When you get an error, simply copy and paste it into Google. And over time, you'll keep running into a website called Stack Overflow. This is the website for your programming questions and errors. And if you can't find what you're looking for, simply submit a question. I do have one additional bonus resource for you. It's a book called Python Crash Course by Eric Mathis. The book is great as it goes over fundamentals, and after each chapter, you get a set of exercises to practice those fundamentals. Plus, at the end of the book, there are 3 projects: an alien invasion game, a data visualization project, and a web application project. Plus, what makes this book amazing is the author also talks about writing good code. How to style your code, how to add comments, and how to even add test cases. I'll include a link to this book in the description below, along with all the other resources that I mentioned. I hope these resources and projects will help you get started with learning how to code. Before you go, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. And also tell me about your progress in the comment below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.